This is the portrait of a veteran. This is the portrait of a man who is ready to do whatever his country asked. This is the portrait of a veteran who would fight again, if he could. No, he wasn't wounded. It wasn't an enemy shot that crippled him. It's not a wound of battle that makes him walk this way. Yet this soldier was crippled by the war. He was one of the tens of thousands of men who were mobilized. Away from home, away from friends, away from old habits, he was struck by an enemy in the blood, by a germ. The spirochete, the germ that causes syphilis. Syphilis that came and seemed to go away, but stayed in the blood to cripple him later on. This is the portrait of a veteran of World War I, a portrait of one of the thousands of soldiers taken from duty by syphilis, one of the thousands crippled, some killed, by the enemy in the blood. But this is a sickness and a death that is preventable. Syphilis can be fought and beaten. And in the laboratory, they are fighting it. In the laboratory, they've found new and powerful weapons against syphilis. There's the microscope test that searches out the spirochete and helps the doctor find the early infection. There's the blood test that can search the blood for syphilis. Doctors send blood samples here for laboratory testing. And the technician examines the blood and finds negative. This patient is not infected. Negative. This patient is not infected. Positive. Danger. This patient may have syphilis. Then the doctor examines him for other signs and does a second blood test to check the first. And if the patient is infected, then he can be treated. The infection can be fought with the weapons of the laboratory. And the infection can be conquered if the patient takes the full course of treatment. The laboratory has found the chemicals that cure syphilis, bismuth, mercury, and arsenic. Early treatment with these chemicals is insurance against a child born dead or crippled, insurance against a heart weakened by syphilis. Yes, the battle in the laboratory is well fought, but this is only half the fight. Here is where the other half of the fight must be made. Here in the schools and colleges. Here where syphilis strikes at the fighting strength of the country, in the Navy. And among the soldiers, here we must fight. And in the mills and plants where the nation's work is done. Here where the people are, this is where venereal disease strikes. And this is where the other half of the fight must be fought. It can only be fought here, among the people and by the people. By people who know the enemy, how he strikes and how to strike back. Know the danger spots of the city. The places where the disease begins. The places that infect the city and infect its people. The places with the easy pickups. Yes, these are the danger spots. The places that breed syphilis. Know the other danger spots, the dark, the hidden streets, the places that are whispered about. These are the danger spots. Here the disease begins. Yes, here it begins. Here a new chain of infection starts, a chain of infection that will take lives of children to be born and bring people to hospitals, to insanity, and to blindness. Here it begins and spreads from one part of the city to another. from one person to many people. One infected person carrying infection to many people, and the infection spreading from them to countless others. And with the disease come the quacks, the charlatans who thrive wherever people are ignorant, who bring disaster wherever people have failed to fight syphilis, the quacks who promise cures, but never cure. Don't worry, kid, I can cure you. It's no worse than a bad cold. I'll clear it up for you. Here, drink this. Cure is guaranteed. 30 years a specialist in men's diseases. $1 a bottle, it's cheap, kid. You can't go wrong with this stuff. You can't go wrong. You can't go wrong. You can't go wrong. But he can go wrong. He will go wrong unless the people fight with knowledge, with treatment, with blood tests, to search the enemy out. Yes, the people must fight to guard against the blindness that syphilis may cause, to prevent the insanity the disease can bring, to prevent the crippling, the broken minds, the twisted limbs, the suffering and the poverty. All these the people must fight. And the fight must be swift and hard, because every day the casualties mount. Thousands are sick and idle, and important jobs are left undone. Production is sabotaged by syphilis. And men already under arms are struck by the disease. In 1917, the army lost 7 million days from active duty. Syphilis is the sniper, the saboteur behind the lines. But it strikes not in the field, not in the camps, but in the towns. That is where syphilis must be fought. So if the people learn, if they'll go to the doctors and the clinics to find the skills that will make them safe, if each person will guard himself, he can help destroy this waster of America. He can save his own and the nation's strength for production, for the nation's security, for all the work and joy of living. The people can raise this shadow from the land, from their homes, if the people learn, if they fight syphilis.